in the world do bees make honey?
Once the temperatures start to rise and we leave the winter behind, plants begin to sprout and bloom, birds return from their winter homes, and bees become, well, busy as bees. Let's find out more. In order to get the buzz about bees, the Airship Curiosity has traveled to a place where there are plenty of hornets, F-18s of the Navy jet fighter variety at Naval Air Station Oceana in Virginia Beach. And yet, within a stone's throw of the runway, there's a quiet spot where bees are carrying on like they always do.
A bee is an insect. It's the only insect that makes food eaten by man. It's a very beneficial insect.
There are numerous kinds of honeybees, and it's the honeybee that we rely upon for pollination. And pollination is how we get our fruits and vegetables.
The honeybee is a vegetarian, so they're looking for pollen, and they want to bring pollen back. Well, plants kind of bribe the honeybee to come to bloom by having a sweet nectar.
Nectar is a sweet liquid produced by flowers and collected by bees and other insects. The bees collect that nectar and bring it back to the colony where the nectar is turned into honey. And they sense that nectar in a very different way.
I think it's the smell. Bees can smell with their feet, their antennae, but basically they're looking for a food source, and they're bringing that food back to the colony, and then that's their food. That's what they eat.
A bee colony has specific roles for its members.
Basically, a colony has one queen. She's the mother of all bees in the colony. Inside, there are worker bees or female bees. Most bees that people ever see are the foragers, the oldest bee in a colony. As soon as a bee is born, it takes on a role. First thing it does is cleans its own cell by cleaning its room. So then it takes on a housekeeper role. It could be building wax. It could be an undertaker. But finally, it works its way to the front door. Once it becomes a forager, that's the bees that most people see. Then you have drones, the male bees. Drone means idler, so they don't do a whole lot of things. Their main role is to mate with a virgin queen and keep the colonies, another colony surviving. The foragers, basically they're the oldest bee in the colony. The average bee lives 6 weeks, roughly 45 days. So a forager will go out and they'll spend an hour or two going from flower to flower to flower, picking up pollen and nectar. They bring it back. As soon as they get back, they come to the front door. They hand off what they collected to a house bee. The house bee will take it inside. They'll put pollen in pollen cells. They'll put the nectar in nectar cells. And then there's house bees that inside that actually take the nectar. And basically, they evaporate the water out of it and use special enzymes in their body and turn it into honey.
From the outside, a beehive doesn't look that complicated, but just take a look on the inside.
Well, inside the colony, we have what we call frames. They're removable. Bees build wax on these frames, and on these frames they build cells. The cells are kind of like the furniture that we have, our closets. It's a place where they store things. The baby bees are raised in a cell. They store their honey. They store their pollen. But they build cells on each frame. They put honey and nectar kind of on the outside. They raise the baby bees on the inside. Bees are extremely efficient at what they do.
Once the water has been evaporated from the nectar, then it is turned into honey. It's capped in a cell like a lid on a jar. Then if it's needed, the bees will uncap it and spread it around the colony, and that feeds them all.